Hi, my name is Sven Seys and I'm going to talk you through the results of our recent study validating the cutoff value applied by the skin prick automated test device in birch pollen and house's mite allergic patients. So skin prick testing is a commonly used method for the diagnosis of allergies because of its high accuracy. However, in the real life setting, it requires trained personnel and is operator dependent, leading to variability. So SPAT has been developed to address these shortcomings by applying 12 pricks simultaneously on the forearm of the patient with a controlled prick pressure and a controlled amount of allergen. So in the first study already published in 23 in Allergy, we have seen that this leads to reduced variability when we compared the automated to a manual test procedure. Because of the use of a bifurcated lancet and the prick method, including a clockwise rotation, the absolute wheel size is larger when compared to the single-headed metal lancets, which you can see here. So this leads to an adjusted cutoff value of 4.5 millimeters instead of the 3 millimeters that is used with the manual pricking. In this study, in collaboration with Dr. Alina Kerasim and Professor Frederic Deblay from Strasbourg, we have set up a study in patients with house's mite or birch pollen allergy, confirmed through a nasal allergen challenge and non-allergic controls. So all of these patients got on the one arm an automated test and on the other arm a conventional skin prick test with the two major house's mite allergens, birch pollen positive and negative control. So looking at the main results, we could demonstrate an equivalent accuracy with SPAT using the 4.5 millimeters compared to a manual skin prick test using the 3 millimeters. So we had an accuracy for the house's mite of 96% compared to 98% with the manual prick test. Specificity was 100% in both cases. And sensitivity was 92% with SPAT compared to 96% with the manual method. Looking at the results in more detail, we can see the top three graphs with the skin prick automated results and the lower graphs with the conventional or manual skin prick tests. So in panel A and D in non-allergic controls, we can see that all tests were negative except for the histamine control, which is positive in both with both methods. Looking at the house's mite allergic patients, we could demonstrate sensitization to either the pteronisus or the farine allergen, both for the skin prick automated test and the conventional skin prick test. However, one patient was negative both in the automated as well as the manual method, and only one patient was missed with the automated method, but not with the manual method. And then in the birch pollen allergic patients, all patients showed sensitization to the birch pollen allergen, both in the automated as well as in the manual method. Looking at the measurements, either via the traditional methods or a digital measurement with the SPAT web viewer, we could not detect significant differences in the longest wheel diameters between the two methods applied, so confirming the usefulness of the digital measurement through SPAT. In conclusion, we could demonstrate an equivalent accuracy of SPAT using the 4.5 millimeter cutoff value and conventional skin prick testing using the 3 millimeter cutoff. We could also show that the SPAT web viewer can be used easily and effectively for the digital measurement of the longest wheel diameter. So this study is important because we could demonstrate and validate the SPAT outcomes in a well-characterized population of allergic rhinitis patients with clinically relevant respiratory allergy. And this will now allow the widespread use of the device both in research as well as in clinical practice. So we are hopeful that introducing SPAT into routine clinical practice may create a new standard in skin prick testing by reducing the test variability while maintaining high sensitivity. So I thank you for your attention.